Hello and greetings, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of DGS2 Case 5 with a rare appearance of actually a save loading file, because when we left off, we were actually caught in the middle of a to-be-continued. So yes, we are here in the savings point, Furnace. So we're heading back into the core after learning a lot of things, in particular a assassination exchange that involved Ahsoki, and that was a thing. Let's see how this all plays out when we get back into the courtroom. Probably not well for Ahsoki, but, you know. Honey, why did you accept an assassination program? You had all the qualifications already to go to Britain. Why did you need to also accept the assassination? Why? November 4th, 9:30 a.m., the Old Bailey Supreme Court.
There's something I'd like to state before we begin today's trial. More shocking facts have come to light during this case regarding the top-secret trial 10 years ago. An organization known as the Grim Reaper, who illegally executes defendants who escape their punishments in court, exists. At its center was a skilled detective, and in the midst of carrying out an assassination attempt, he became a victim himself. I would like to declare to all the members of the justice system gathered here in this courtroom today that today is the day that we will hunt down the truth so that not so much as a speck of doubt remains. Both sides will conduct the trial with the resolve to do just that.
Resolve. Your Honor, there's one thing I'd like to inquire about.
What is it, defendant?
Why is Ahsoki Kazuma still behind the prosecutor's bench today? This man accompanied the victim to carry out an assassination. I should think that should render him completely unworthy of prosecuting.
I submitted a petition to Lord Heart Vortex, requesting that he hold off on delivering my punishment for just one day.
What?
I plan to make everything clear over the course of today's trial. You could even say that my whole life for these past 10 years has been for this very purpose.
Ahsoki.
Regardless of what form the conclusion of this trial takes, I have sworn to take any heavy punishment necessary afterwards. You do well to participate in this trial with that same level of resolve, Grim Reaper.
Damn it, Ahsoki. His entire body is positively radiating murderous intent. What's this dangerous premonition I'm getting all of a sudden? Is the person standing over there really Kazuma-sama?
Though it is highly irregular, I accept this man as a prosecutor. Am I understood, defense?
Yes, Your Honor.
Now then, in the name of Her Majesty the Queen, I declare court to be reconvened. We will now resume the trial for the defendant Baroque Van Zeeks.
The defense is ready.
So is the prosecution.
At this point in the proceedings, there should be no need for any preface. Therefore, you may begin, Prosecutor Ahsoki.
In that case, I'd like to call my first witness right away. Escort Jigoku Sechiro to the stand.
It's finally time for the final battle. He staked everything in order to stand there and seek the truth. better steel yourself. You better steel your resolve and face him head on. Not Aldo Ryonosuke.
Now then, witness, kindly state your name and profession.
Ha ha! So it was you, was it? The one who issued this?
A subpoena. I only did what was necessary.
Ha 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 ha! Looks like you've gotten a little too big for your own britches, boy. To think you'd end up mouthing off to me like this someday.
Witness, you will answer the questions you were asked.
My name is Jigoku Seishiro. I'm a judge in the great Japanese Empire.
16 years ago, he visited London as a legal program exchange student and returned home to Japan 10 years ago. In addition to being a judge, he's also currently acting as the Great Japanese Empire's Minister of Foreign Affairs.
Naturally, I'm familiar with his name. I invited him to the International Scientific Investigation Symposium as a judge to represent Japan. I hear that he also played a large role in the execution of the Anglo-Japanese Nautical Peace Treaty.
Oh, what an honor. I really poured my heart and soul into that one.
Judge Jigoku, if I may.
Oh, have you been there the whole time, little murderer?
Wow! Like I said before, I was found innocent, and I'm a defense attorney now.
Looks like you've gotten a little too big for your britches, too.
You received an invitation to the International Scientific Investigation Symposium and came to visit London. Oh my god, that word again! And yet, without saying a word to anyone, you headed for France and tried to flee.
Flee, huh? You don't mince words, do you?
Why did you do such a thing? Please, explain your reason.
Yeah, I figured you'd ask that. In regards to that... I refuse.
Huh?
I'm deeply sorry for just turning around and leaving England when I was invited here as a guest, but... I have nothing to do with this case, nor do I have any obligation to testify.
Nothing to do with it.
I heard that a London detective was murdered. I offer my sympathies, of course, but... there's no way a foreigner like me would know that detective. Therefore, I have nothing I can testify about. That's all.
You intend to flee again?
What did you say?
This case isn't only about the murder of Gregson-sama. It also connected to the murder case that occurred last year in the Great Japanese Empire.
A year ago. You mean Professor John H. Watson?
Plus, Judge Jigoku, you have an important role in all of this. I have evidence to prove it. Oh no!
I can tell by your expression, Naruhodo. You have the resolve to pursue this as well.
We gotta present the telegram, don't we?
In that case, why don't you present it? What is the evidence that indicates a connection between Mr. Jigoku Seishiro and this case?
I'm so sorry, Asogi, but we really do gotta get to the bottom of this. I have here an international telecommunications record between England and Japan. It was transmitted a year ago and contains four names. K. Asogi, A. Sasha, T. Gregson, J. Watson.
Hold it! Damn you! Where on earth did you get that?
From your office in Tokyo, Judge Jugoku.
Ridiculous! When did you manage to...
What's the meaning of this? What's my name doing on there?
There's a certain pattern to these names. T. Gregson and J. Watson are both the names of victims. K. Asogi and A. Sasha are the names of the assassins who accepted hits on those two. Last year in Tokyo, the imperial capital of the Great Japanese Empire, Dr. John H. Watson was murdered in a restaurant. The killer in that case was an exchange student who called herself Giselle Bullitt. Her true name was Anne Sasha. She was an assassin sent from the Great British Empire. Give me one second. There's a piece of text that's missing here. I just want to make sure we include it for my... I want to make sure this is included for my dear person who's going to be reading Jugoku later. Anyway, Okay, A. Sasha and J. Watson. And this case that occurred here in London can be considered the reciprocal of that. The assassin dispatched from Japan, Asogi Kazuma, was also an exchange student. And the victim was a detective from the Great British Empire, Mr. Tobias Gregson. Hey Asogi and T. Gregson. The assassin dispatched from Japan to England, and the English victim.
Dear Lord.
The Great British Empire and the Great Japanese Empire. These two murders were planned by two masterminds as an overseas assassin exchange. And this communications record is proof of that contract.
What?
This record was found in your chambers, Judge Jugoku. In other words, the Japanese mastermind would have to be you.
Judge Jugoku, what is the meaning of this?
Also, Asogi, you lied, didn't you? During yesterday's trial, you admitted to having accepted the assassination mission. But the target wasn't Judge Jugoku. It was Detective Gregson. The name written in this record proves it!
I should have expected as much from you, Naruhodo. But I didn't lie. I never said the name of the target I was ordered to assassinate.
It's true, he didn't. You sneaky bastard.
You were the one who assumed that it was Jugoku Seshiro.
You withheld it. On purpose, didn't you?
You claim that these four names indicate an assassin exchange. I'm afraid that sounds like a pipe dream to me. Incredibly hard to believe. Well, Mr. Jugoku?
That silence. Does that mean you admit it? And there's one more important fact here. It's possible that the place where the victim, Greg Sensama, was actually murdered was a cabin aboard the steamship Bar Block. In which case, Judge Jigoku, you can't escape having to testify.
Come on, don't glare like that. You're still so young. Very well then, I'll tell you everything as a little gift from my trip to London.
It seems as though we'll need to hear what this Japanese man has to say. Regarding the fearsome assassin exchange and what happened on the night of October 31st, the court orders you to testify.
As you wish, Your Honor.
Assassin Exchange.
It's true. I gave Asogi Kazuma an assassination mission last year. The target was Detective T. Gregson. That was the condition for his English study abroad. However, in the end, he became unable to fulfill that mission. The night of the incident, there were crew members patrolling in front of the cabin doors for regular security. If there'd been a gunshot, they would have heard it. That means I have nothing to do with this murder!
I don't know, we did find, like, the thing where that Briggs announcement, it got muffled. That's a weird device horn thing, I don't know what it's called right now. So then, it's just as indicated by this record. There actually was a transaction for exchanging assassins, wasn't there?
It's high-level governmental stuff. I can't talk about it here.
Oh, you can totally talk about it here. It's a frickin' private court case right now. Making an assassination the condition for his study abroad in the Great British Empire. What a cowardly transaction.
Cowardly, huh? I wonder about that. Asogi Kazuma had a reason to murder that English detective.
What?
That's precisely why he accepted the mission. Isn't that right, Asogi Kazuma?
Kazuma-sama. Judge Jigoku, if you were in fact the mastermind on the Japanese side, then who was the person on the English side who made the exchange with you?
I have no need to tell you that.
As I said yesterday, I didn't kill anyone. I admit that I accepted the mission, but I didn't carry it out that night. In other words, the assassin exchange you mentioned has nothing to do with this case.
There's only one important thing here.
I'm so sorry. I don't know what I was... I think it's because I'm so used to reading the judge, so I see a J in the script, so I'm just like reading out of habit. My bad.
And that's that the English detective wasn't killed aboard the steamship at Dunkirk Harbor. If a gun had been fired in my cabin, the crew would have heard it.
Precisely. After Detective Gregson returned to London, he was murdered on Fresno Street. And the one who took him out was the Grim Reaper. Baroque Van Zeeks. The prosecution's claim hasn't changed.
To think that an exchange like this could be lurking behind the legal exchange program last year. It's a plot that only could have been carried out by the witness, who is both a judge and the Minister of Foreign Affairs.
I seem to recall that the one who approached me about the deal was the one in this country, though.
Regardless, the matter this trial is dealing with is not the suspicious assassin exchange. This is purely concerning Detective Gregson's murder. Am I understood, defense?
I don't know. There's something really fishy going around here. I think Vortex is trying to avoid it. Yes, Your Honor. I will now conduct my cross-examination. Vortex is, dodging something here. Alright, let's get into this. Alright. We're going to present something. One, second, third, fourth statement. So, they were not all patrolling the whole time. Wait, whoops. Okay, we have new dialogue. I don't have this, so, Hikari can have fun translating this. I was supposed to present something here, but I pressed instead. But that's okay, we have new dialogue that we can add in now. Why is there just so much kanji? It's like, well, I can recognize a couple more now, but there's just still like 500 million more kanjis here I still don't recognize. I can't wait to see the translation for this later. Are they talking about the Alcrate? I mean, they bring up Mabudov, so I'm just like, are they talking about Stroganov? Oh, there's Bar Block right there. I'm sorry. Alright, back to it now. So we're back in this statement. Present a lot of evidence. This. That's what I meant to do. That's true. It does indeed seem that there were crew members posted outside Judge Jigoku's cabin for security. However, at the very least, that wasn't normal.
What?
I have here a notification regarding the plans for the day of October 31st.
Damn you! Where did you...
The detective, Mr. Sherlock Holmes, obtained it as evidence. You must have run into him yesterday as well.
Sherlock Holmes.
According to this activity schedule, for a span of 20 minutes at 10 p.m. after departure from Dunkirk, all the members of the crew on the RFS Bar Block gather up on deck.
The crew all left their posts?
During this 20-minute gap, even if a gunshot had been fired in your cabin, there would have been no one around to hear it. Which means, Judge Jigoku, that you had an opportunity to commit the murder.
A 20-minute gap, huh? What a fascinating theory, Naruhodo. But there's no point in trying to rely on possibilities at this point.
What do you mean?
The witness has clearly testified that the murder didn't occur in his cabin. Unless you have decisive evidence in order to dismantle the testimony. There's no point in quibbling over possibilities.
A fair point. Well, defense.
Detective Gregson was murdered that night in Judge Igoku's cabin. And I've got the evidence to prove it. You know what I feel? This is such a very fun parallel right now, because here's Naruhodo, and here's Jigoku. And I'm just reminded of the very first case when Naruhodo was defending himself and, you know, trying to do the defense attorney thing. We've come full circle, basically. I think it's amazing.
In that case, the court orders the defense to present that evidence. What is the evidence that indicates that the victim was murdered in Jikoku's cabin on October 31st?
Well, before we can present this, we have to actually examine it first. I feel like I've seen something similar pretty frequently. The thing that sticks out of the top of a pocket watch. You twist it in order to set the time. It's called the crown. It's a necessary part for a clock. A crown. Seems like a rather exaggerated name. But, more importantly... Right. This is a crown. I feel like I know of a king who happens to have lost his crown. We better have another good look. Alright. There are... 6 pages of evidence now, by the way. Something wrong, Susato-san. It's the shape of this hole. I feel like we have something that should fit it perfectly. You're right. Actually, I was thinking the same thing. Perhaps this part belongs to Gregson-sama's broken pocket watch. Yeah, I was just thinking the same thing. It fits perfectly. Whoa. It's just like we thought. He's looking at me doubtfully. I mean, you keep repeating everything she claims, so yes. In any case, let's make a note of this information. Small part found in Judge Igoku's cabin. Actually the crown to Detective Gregson's watch. Alright, so we're now presenting the small piece. Not the watch, but the small piece. Holy shit. There's so much evidence. Judge Jigoku, this was found in your cabin.
That appears to be a crown from a broken pocket watch.
A watch?
And if you direct your attention to this now, this was the victim's beloved broken pocket watch. And as you can see, the crown is missing.
You can't mean...
And this crown fits the victim's pocket watch perfectly. The fact that this was lying in Judge Igoku's cabin means that the victim's broken pocket watch was broken there. That is a sentence. Broken pocket watch was broken there. In other words, the victim's time of death was the 31st during that 20-minute gap. In your cabin, Judge Jigoku.
Not bad, little murderer.
That's some impressive proof, Naruhodo. Your claim does indeed sound plausible. However, it's covered in cracks, just like this pocket watch.
What?
And it appears that his honor shares my opinion.
I can't help remembering last year when I gave you that not guilty verdict.
Right.
If I'd known that I'd have to listen to such worthless claims later as a result, perhaps the world would have been better off if I declared you guilty.
Wow! Hell no! Punch him!
It would seem that we'll need to have this witness testify once more.
You want to know what happened in my cabin that night? Once you hear it, you ought to notice the pitfall in your theory.
Before you testify, there's just one thing I'd like to confirm. Considering that this piece was found in your room, do you admit to the fact that the victim visited your cabin?
Yes, I admit it.
Very well. In that case, the court requires further testimony. Regarding what happened in your cabin on the night of October 31st.
As a judge from the great Japanese Empire, I have no intention of withholding my cooperation.
Sure you don't. I don't believe you one bit. Alright, we gotta stop here for now, and we're gonna listen to his testimony about what happened in that ship cabin in the next video. So I'll see you guys then. I hope he stops calling Naruhodo Little Murderer, because I want to punch him.